Good morning, everyone. Hi, my name is Nasir Memon. I'm a professor in the computer science and engineering department at NYU Tandon. And I want to take a few minutes. First of all, I want to thank you for being here today. It's really great that you could make it. I know many of you are very busy and you have sort of important things to do, but the fact that you're here for this event indicates that you think that this is an important topic, right? You're here to talk, we are here to talk about women leaders in cybersecurity, closing the gender gap, and we understand that this is indeed an important topic, and I won't sort of waste my time trying to convince you that it's important, right? We know that. Let's leave that aside. The question is, of course, what can we do about it? And the honest answer is, I don't know. But I can tell you a little bit about my own personal experience and some of the things that we have done, and share some of that with you. And throughout the day, you will hear from other highly sort of accomplished leaders in cybersecurity field much more about what they think can be done. So this gender gap, at least in STEM and computer science, was always very visible to me. Right, since I was a grad student 100 years ago, you could look around in the classroom and there were no women, right? But I kind of ignored it and whatever, you kind of didn't think about it. And then in, I think, first time when I started understanding the problem from the women's point of view was when I was talking to my wife. We were not married then, we were students in PhD students together, and she used to be the only woman in many of these advanced classes that we used to do together, right? She used to always do better than me, that's a different story. And one day she was talking about how stressful it was. She started telling me about how stressful it was just being the only woman in that class, and really the saving grace for, quite often for her, was having a woman professor there. How important it was for her to see that. And I kind of at that time realized that this is a bigger problem than simply numbers. There's more here going on. The numbers are a symptom, right? What is going on is deeper than that. But still, I said, yeah, that's a deeper problem. I kind of moved on, right? And then I graduated, I became a professor, and I was seeing it all the time in my classes, right? And you develop what Salman Rushdie called the city eyes. You see, but you don't see, right? You just say, okay, you accept it, and you move on. You kind of, in some sense, ignore it. I think the first time that I decided to do something about it was at an event called Seesaw that some of you know about that I'd been organizing for a long time. And Seesaw has 10, 20,000 students, 30,000 students, whatever the numbers vary, and it's hard to count them, that participate. And among those participants, we pick the finalists, the top 10, and we bring them to New York for a two-day finals. It's going to be November, by the way, if you don't know about it. Google it, Seesaw, NYU, and please come and attend. And I was standing in the gym, and I was looking at all the finalists. They gather in the gym, and they're all hacking away, whatever they do. And I noticed there was not a single woman in the finalists, zero, right? And I kind of thought this was wrong. And at that was the first time I felt responsible saying, I should do something about it, right? And so we started doing a lot of things. We started programs to get high school teachers to teach them cybersecurity, women teachers, and then go back and be role models and mentors for their students. Because one thing I clearly remembered was what my wife has said, right? The saving grace for her was the women professors in the class. That really sort of saved the day. And so we thought that one of the sort of an important thing to do was create the right mentors. So we started having summer camps for high school teachers. We started running summer camps for high school girls, and we still do that. Every summer, we take in about 50 or 75 women students from high school and train them in cybersecurity and then encourage them to participate in Seesaw, et cetera, et cetera. This year, we got some NSF funding to start going out to the schools and starting off extracurricular cybersecurity clubs in the high schools for women, women-only cybersecurity clubs in high schools, and we will be starting that sometime this spring. So there's sort of different things we started doing, and this year, I was looking at the Seesaw finalists. They're not here, of course. I mean, we haven't held the finals yet, but we know the finalists. The preliminaries are over, and the situation has not really changed that much, right? So there's still challenges. I mean, at NYU Tandon, we've done a lot about STEM and computer science. In the 3 years I was a department head, we moved our enrollment in computer science from 20% to 37%, right? And all of NYU Tandon also has reached numbers that are similar. That we have 37% women enrolled. But in cybersecurity, we are still not seeing that. And so I hope today we will get to hear from leaders in cybersecurity and get a better understanding of what is it that we could do to address this problem. Don't get me wrong, it's not as if I've not studied it to some extent. We've even written papers about it and done surveys and things of that sort. But still, seeing what we see today, the things, there's still a lot more to be done. I look forward to hearing from the panelists and the keynote speakers assembled here today. A really great team. Thank you so much for taking time from your busy schedule and being here. And to the other women in the audience and men as well, it's an important problem, and we are eager to work with you to somehow address this and change the landscape. And I hope what we hear today helps us move forward in that direction.